Good morning all. I welcome you in the sweet name of Lord Jesus Christ in this online World Memorial Church service. Let's begin this service. Praise the Lord, O my soul. I will praise the Lord all my life. I will sing praise to my God as long as I live. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we want to thank you, we want to praise your holy name in this beautiful Sunday worship morning. You have given to us to come to your presence and adore you, worship you and magnify you, Almighty Lord. Thank you for your love, your protection, your care, your healing in last week, Almighty Lord. Thank you once again, you brought us together through this online social media platform to worship you, to adore you. I want to pray to you, Almighty Lord. You take this service, and through this service, your name will be glorified and magnified. I pray this prayer in Jesus' name. We all say, Amen. This time we will sing hymn number 45, and we'll give honor and glory to our Almighty God.
Jesus, our blessed Redeemer, sing, O earth, His wonderful love proclaim. Hail Him, hail Him, highest of regents in glory, strength and honor give to His holy name. Like a shepherd, Jesus will guide His children. In His arms He carries them all day long. Oh, He sings out, dwell in the mountains of Zion. Praise Him, ever a joyful song. Jesus, our blessed Redeemer, for our sins He suffered and bled and died. He, our rock, our hope of eternal salvation. Hail Him, hail Him, Jesus the Crucified. Loving Savior, meekly enduring sorrow, that cruelly pierced His brow. Once for us rejected, despised and forsaken, Prince of glory, ever triumphant now. Praise Him, Jesus our blessed Redeemer. Heavenly portals, love with Hosanna ring. Jesus, Savior, reigneth forever and ever. Crown Him, prophet and priest and king. Death is vanquished, tell it with joy faithful. Where is now thy victory boasting grave? Jesus lives no longer, thy portals are cheerless. Jesus lives the mighty and strong to save.
This time, prayerfully, we all say the Apostle Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead and buried. He descended into hell. The third day He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and seated at the right hand of the God the Father Almighty. From thence He shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. This time we have a response reading. The response reading has been taken from Psalm number 38, and may I call Anisim to please come forward and lead us in responsive reading.
For today's responsive reading, let us turn our Bibles to Psalm 38. Psalm 38, I read. O Lord, do not rebuke me in your anger, or discipline me in your wrath.
For your arrows have pierced me, and your hand has come down upon me.
Because of your wrath there is no health in my body. My bones have no soundness because of my sin.
My guilt has overwhelmed me, like a burden too heavy to bear.
My wounds fester and are loathsome because of my sinful folly.
I am bowed down and brought very low. All day long I go about mourning.
My back is filled with searing pain. There is no health in my body.
I am feeble and utterly crushed. I groan in anguish of heart.
All my longings lie open before you, O Lord. My sighing is not hidden from you.
My heart pounds. My strength fails me. Even the light has gone from my eyes.
My friends and companions avoid me because of my wounds. My neighbors stay far away.
Those who seek my life set their traps. Those who would harm me talk of my ruin. All day long they plot deception.
I am like a deaf man who cannot hear, like a mute who cannot open his mouth.
I have become like a man who does not hear, whose mouth can offer no reply.
I wait for you, O Lord. You will answer, O Lord my God.
For I said, do not let them gloat or exalt them over me when my foot slips.
For I am about to fall, and my pain is ever with me.
I confess my iniquity. I am troubled by my sin.
Many are those who are my vigorous enemies. Those who hate me without reason are numerous.
Those who repay my good with evil slander me when I pursue what is good.
O Lord, do not forsake me. Do not far away from me, O my God.
Come quickly to help me, O Lord, my Savior.
May the good Lord bless this scripture reading.
Now this time, choir will lead us in special song.
That is who you are. when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop working. You never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop working. You never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop working. You never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop working. You never stop working. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are.
Waymaker, you are.
Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. 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 That is who you are.
Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we want to thank you, want to give honor and praise to your holy name for this beautiful time you have given to us to come to your presence and pray for each other, church and people, Almighty Lord. Dear Lord, we want to thank you and to praise you. Whatever we asked in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, you are there to listen and answering our prayers, Almighty Lord. This time we especially pray for our Valor Memorial Church and today's online this service. Take this service in mighty and thy hand as we pray to you, O Lord Almighty. You bless this service, you bless each and every through this service in miraculously and wonderfully way, Lord. Lord, especially we pray for our church, our each and every member of this world church, Almighty Lord. You give them peace, you give them good healing, strengthen them and provide their all the needs in miraculously and beautifully way in days to come, Almighty Lord. Especially we want to pray for those who are infected from coronavirus, those who are in hospital, in home. Oh Almighty Lord, you be with them, you guide them, you lead them, you strengthen them, you give them hope, peace and healing miraculously and beautifully, Almighty Lord. We want to pray to you, you be with them, Almighty Lord. And also whatever they have plans and purpose and the needs in their life, you provide them beautifully way, Almighty Lord. Also we want to pray for our each and every church committee. Our Almighty, bless each and every our church committee. Especially we want to pray for C, our youth, Sunday school, our children's and choir committee, and also all the committees of this church, Almighty Lord. Be with them and guide them and strengthen them and give them good health in this pandemic situation. Also we want to pray for our station members as they are taking responsibility of this church and various activities and administration way. You be with them, you guide them, you strengthen them, you give them good health, knowledge and wisdom in this situation to move forward with your vision and mission to betterment of extension of your kingdom, Almighty Lord. Especially we want to thank you, we want to praise your holy name for our Pastor Reverend D.B. Samudre. You heal him completely, Almighty Lord. Thank you for that. As he discharged from hospital, we want to pray to you. You give them good health, give them good peace and strengthen them, give them power so he can come back again and do ministry while in our church miraculously and beautifully. We want to thank you, Reverend Kali's family, Lord Almighty, for healing, Almighty Lord. Also we want to pray for all our pastors, our evangelists, all our workers of Wild River Church. You be with them, guide them, lead them and provide them all the needs miraculously and beautifully way, Almighty Lord. Also we want to pray for our evangelical work in western region of Kolhapur area. You be with our evangelist Sanne and his family. You want to submit his whole work to mighty and thy hand, Almighty Lord. Also, we want to pray for our newcomers people, our believers in various towns and villages, Almighty Lord. You be with them, guide them, and also heal them completely in this pandemic situation. Also, we want to pray for our city Kolhapur, our district Kolhapur, Almighty Lord, as the corona cases once again increasing in numbers, you take care of this, you handle this situation as our governing body, our DM, our CEO, as they are planning to come down, decrease the corona cases numbers and the death ratio. Almighty Lord, you be with them, guide them, and whatever their plan and purpose for this beautiful district and city, oh Almighty Lord, you give them success miraculously way, so that increasing numbers will come down, and that will be all the conditions will come back again in a natural, Almighty Lord. Also, we want to pray for our state Maharashtra, our governor, our chief minister, their cabinet ministers. Be with them, guide them, give them a good health, give them your grace, mercy in this situation, Almighty Lord. Whatever they have a plan and purpose to betterment of Maharashtra and the hurdles and the challenges and the concerns for this Maharashtra people, oh Almighty Lord, you be with them and guide them, and each and every plan and purpose, you give them success and betterment of this Maharashtra people, Almighty Lord. Also, we want to pray for our nation India, our Prime Minister, our President, and also their Cabinet Minister, Almighty Lord. You be with them, guide them, give them your peace, give them your grace and mercy in this situation, Almighty Lord. As our India's in situation is where there are so many hurdles, challenges and the concerns, oh Almighty Lord, we want to pray to you. You take this country for your glory, Almighty Lord. We want to pray for all the world church, Almighty Lord, the mission organizations and various our pastors and evangelists and missionaries. They are working in various parts of this India. Oh Almighty Lord, you be with them, you guide them, heal them completely, strengthen them, give them peace, give them good health in this pandemic situation, and whatever they have plan and purpose and the mission and the vision for in this pandemic situation towards the church and the society and the nation, we want to pray to you. You provide their all the needs miraculously and beautifully way. As your servant Reverend Ashok Chogule sir is going to preach from your word, oh Almighty Lord, we want to pray to you. You speak through him miraculously and wonderfully way, and whatever your plan and purpose for your church, your people, you speak with him through us, Almighty Lord. We want to submit each and everyone once again your mighty and thy hand. Thank you for listening and answering our prayers. I pray this prayer in Jesus' name. You all say Amen.
Good morning, church, and welcome you to this praise and worship service of Wilder Memorial Church. And yet, it's an honor to come before you once again to lead you into worship, to praise our Almighty Savior, and encourage you all to join us as we sing this beautiful song. And wherever you are, you can just lift your hands and give praise and thanks to God Almighty. Amen.
Light of the world, you step down into darkness. Open my eyes, let me see. Beauty that made this heart adore you, hope of the life spent with you. Here I am to worship, here I am to bow down, here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me. King of all days, oh so highly exalted, glorious in heaven above. Humbly you came to the earth you created, but for the sake became poor. Here I am to worship, here I am to bow down, here I am to say that
You're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me.
I'll never know
how much it cost to see my sins upon that cross. I'll never know how much it cost to see my sin upon that cross. Here I am to worship, here I am to bow down, here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me. Here I am to worship, here I am to bow down, here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me.
Amen. Hallelujah. We worship the God who gives us a fulfilling water after drinking, which will never feel thirsty again. Amen. Hallelujah.
Jesus said, come to the water, stand by my side. I know you are thirsty, you won't be denied. I felt every teardrop when in darkness you cried. And I strove to remind you that for those tears I died. You said you'd come and share all my sorrows. You said you'd be there for all my tomorrows. I came so close to sending you away, but just like you promised, I came here to stay. I just had to pray,
I just had to pray.
Jesus said, come to the water, stand by my side. I know you are thirsty, you won't be denied. I felt every teardrop when in darkness you cried. And I strove to remind you that for those tears I died. Your goodness so great I can't understand. And dear Lord, I know that all this was planned. I know you're here now and always will be. In love loose my chains and in you I am free. But Jesus, why me?
But Jesus, why me?
Jesus said, come to the water, stand by my side. I know you are thirsty, you won't be denied. I felt every teardrop when in darkness you cried. And I strove to remind you that for those tears I died. Jesus, I gave you my heart and my soul.
ever be whole. Savior, you opened all the right doors. And I thank you and praise you from earth's humble shores. Take me, I'm yours.
Take me, I'm yours.
Jesus said, come to the water, stand by my side. I know you are thirsty, you won't be denied. I felt every teardrop when in darkness you cried. And I strove to remind you that for those tears I died.
In midst of us today, Mr. Ashok Chogule sir is here. He is going to deliver the word of God. He is the ex-secretary of Wilder Memorial Church, and now presently he is a trustee of Wilder Memorial Church. Now this time may I call sir to please come forward and deliver the word of God.
Shall we pray? Our Heavenly Father, the words of my mouth and meditations of our hearts be acceptable to you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The title of my sermon today is God is in control, are we? Before going into the message, I would like to thank God the Almighty for giving me this an opportunity to speak to you through His scriptures. I also thank Pastor Sensation for allowing me to share the word of God. Now, last couple of years, almost 2 years, we are suffering with COVID-19 or Corona. SARS-CoV-2 virus is making havoc in the world. Whole world is upside down, and the only subject all over world is Corona. Now, so many protocols are, governments have set so many protocols. We have to follow these protocols like distancing, wearing mask, and not going into the rush. All these things, all protocols are followed by us. Now, this epidemic is, it comes sometimes in our lifetime. Now, I heard about 100 years back there was another epidemic. But during our lifetime, I think this will be the first and last epidemic which we will come across. And Jesus or God the Almighty, He is allowing such epidemics for the world. Is it necessary for God, or is it okay? Do we curse God when these epidemics come? Or what? Why God allows such epidemics? Now, diseases are the order of fallen world. As you know, Adam and Eve, when they committed sin, and the sin entered into the world, and since then, these whole population in the world is suffering from these diseases. Now, disease is there, and all our doctors and researchers, scientists, they are working on it, and they are finding some solution, one or the other, and they are trying to manage this disease. But you know that this Corona, so far there is no proper medicine. There is no any medicine by which exactly the Corona will go. And even after the patients are cured, the Corona is still there, and it is causing debilitating effects where person can become weak and susceptible to another infections. So why, the question is now, why God allows such epidemics? Why God allows trials, tests and examinations? Recently, my daughter, she gave DNB examination, and in our practicals, 90% of the questions were asked out of syllabus. And when she came back home, she said, "Papa, 90% questions were out of syllabus. That was not from the pediatric subject. It was from other subjects like radiology and forensic." Similarly, we also come across such epidemics, such diseases, such adverse situations where we puzzle and we ask questions, how, why it has come. It was, we never experienced before, but why does it come now? What is the reason? But let me tell you, my dear friends, everything in God's syllabus, and God allows such adverse situations, trials, tests and examinations in our life with some purpose. And today we are going to see what is God's purpose behind this. Why does God allow such things in our life? And I am going to tell you 4 important things and another 3 things which God expects us to do. So totally 7 things we are going to see from the Bible. Now first, spiritual truth, or out of 4 spiritual truths which are revealed in my message, the first spiritual truth is God works. God works. When we think about this, many times we are doubtful about God's existence. We angrily say whether there is a God or not, why such difficulties are coming. But if you read Romans 8:28, and it is written there, and we know that God works for the good of those who love Him. God is working. God is working all the time, 24 hours, and He is working for goodness of ours. And that thing we should keep it in mind. Whenever we are in pain, sorrow, agony, and lot of difficulties, everything, we should know that God is working, and He is working for our goodness. That is the main important thing. Whatever development is happening in this world, it is for the expansion of His kingdom and extending His kingdom. So, my dear friends, the first spiritual truth you should know about this epidemic is God is working. God is working, and He works for our goodness. Now, when you go to mission hospitals, Christian mission hospitals, there at the entrance, label is written, "We treat, God heals." And this is very much true. God's healing is important. Many times Christians, they deny medicines. They don't take medicines. They think that prayer is the only answer, and prayer can remove all the diseases. Prayer, it is important. Because ultimately, everything is in God's hand. But let me tell you, my dear friends, that if you are taking medicine, take medicine with prayer. And the treating doctors, they will be successful only if God heals, and you will be healed. So remember that we treat, God heals. This is the label. It is written outside the Christian hospitals. Now, why diseases, epidemics, or calamities, or adverse situation come into human life? What is the reason? Since Adam and Eve, they committed sins, the diseases started entering into the world. If you see the Old Testament, all the Israelites, they were suffering such epidemics, so many diseases, and that time they were thinking that some disease is coming, that means some forefathers, they have committed the sin. So sometimes we may think that sin is behind the disease. But now our sins are already forgiven by Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ died on the cross and He has taken our sins. So nowadays we should think that the God is working all the time. And this is the grace period. We are here in the world by the grace of God. Nothing is ours. Nobody can boast ourselves that this is mine, and that is mine, and I did this and I did that. That is not the question. Everything belongs to God. We are going to come empty-handed and we are going to go empty-handed. So remember that the everything is God's. The everything's creation, whatever creation is there in the world, that is everything from God. And God's grace, by God's grace only human life is there. Today I can't say tomorrow if I am alive or not. That is the situation. But we can say by God's grace, if God allows me, or God willing, I may see the tomorrow. So remember, the God works. God always works 24 hours. Now second spiritual truth I would like to talk here, that is God talks. God talks. What does God wish to talk through this pandemic? We should know. Otherwise, we are wasting our time in this valuable problem like COVID-19. We may not experience this COVID-19 again in 100 years or so. We don't know. But people have to turn to God. People should have the intimacy, or people should become lenient to God. They should be prayerful. They should love God. And God wants our intimate fellowship, our close encounters. This is the reason why God is allowing such pandemics into our lives. People should worship the God with truth and spirit. And during, if we look into pre-COVID time, how was our life? And now, during this pandemic, we are running here and there, and lot of things are happening, and lot of media is revealing the effects of this COVID-19. But remember that God is talking. God wants your fellowship and my fellowship, intimate relationship, and your and my encounters with Him. So that is why God is talking through this pandemic. The third important spiritual aspect or spiritual thing is God refines. Third spiritual truth is God refines. God uses adverse situation to secure His will and refine His people. Intense desire to learn the Bible during this pandemic. We know that now everybody is opening their mobile and they are on Zoom. You see, all over the world, people are on Zoom and they are trying to come closer to God. Why this happened? These media gadgets were there before pre-COVID time. There were these media gadgets, but nobody was looking at them. But why only when this epidemic came, all the people are running after media gadgets like Facebook, WhatsApp, like Zoom, Google, and so many things are there, and people are trying to go there and trying to find the God. This is very surprising. When people were having complete freedom, that time they neglected God. But when this pandemic came, then they are trying to come closer to God. So this is the very contrast. So God refines, like, you know, gold. When gold is to be purified, it has to go into the fire, and thousands of degree temperature it has to sustain. Then only that gold will become purified. Similarly, if we want to become spiritually purified, we need God to refine us. And that is the third spiritual truth, where God is going to refine. Now Psalm 122:1, he says, I rejoiced with those who said to me, let us go to the house of the Lord. This is the excitement of David, King David. He says that, I rejoiced with those who said to me, let us go to house of the Lord. Now during this pandemic, the churches are closed, churches are not there, and you have to sit at home and you pray to God. And that time when you remember the previous pre-COVID time, that time you remember churches were open, but nobody used to come to the church. Churches were empty. Only first Sunday of the church there will be rush, but rest of the Sundays churches are empty. This is a very important point every person should think about, because when David is telling, I rejoiced with those who said to me, let us go to the house of the Lord. David is excited, and we also have excitement. Everybody is asking when church is going to open. When is church going to open? They are telephoning him, pastors, and so many people, and asking about the opening of the church. But you know, the church is closed because of this epidemic. God has allowed this epidemic, and as a result, the churches are closed. So remember that third spiritual thing, or third spiritual truth, is God refines. Now, coming to the fourth spiritual truth, is God assures. How have we been able to really discover the hand of God, His sovereignty in this time of distress? Do we believe that God is going to help us out from this epidemic? If not, then we will not be in control. And that is why the title of my message is God is in control, are we? Some of us must have revealed and experienced this as the events unfolded. In close fellowship with God, nothing to worry. When we are really in close fellowship with God, the child of God need not worry. And God, whatever happens in the life of child of God, happens according to His sweet will. And that is why Isaiah 41:10, there is the assurance from God. He says, fear not, for I am with you. And this is the assurance. Yes, I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. This is the assurance Isaiah is giving in his Isaiah chapter 41 and 10th verse. So there is a promise of God. There is the assurance. Nobody should go astray, or nobody should be, they are very nervous that what is going to happen now. Are we going to be alive or not? Are we going to survive this epidemic or not? Whole family is afflicted with this disease. What is going to happen? These are all things, all questions are there. But remember, our important things here are our unwavering faith. Our faith should be strong. And these are the divine weapons, our faith and hope. And these are the promises of God. He has given, He has revealed all His promises. And that is our armor. And so, with unwavering faith and hope, we should face this epidemic. Jesus came to earth to give light to those who sit in darkness and the shadow of death. And that is why, fear not is His assurance to us. Now Luke 1:79, you see, to shine on those living in darkness and in the shadow of death, to guide our feet into path of peace. For this, Jesus came into this world to show the light, because the world was in darkness and it was in sin. But God came, Jesus Christ came, and He showed us the light. Now, many times, because of this epidemic, we are in mental stress and fear. But Jesus asked His disciples, where is your faith? When Jesus was traveling in a boat in the evening time with His disciples, and the great storm came and the boat was about to sink, and the disciples got afraid. They were not knowing what to do now. We are going to die now. And they went, and Jesus was asleep, and they got Him up, and they said, we are dying, Master. this boat is going to be sunk. And then Jesus is asking, where is your faith? These disciples, 24 hours they were with Jesus, but they were not knowing him as Lord Jesus Christ. They were not knowing that Jesus is commanding all nature and everything. He is Lord, and that was the problem with disciples. Today the problem in this epidemic, today same problem we are facing. We have a weak faith. We are thinking, God, Jesus, we are going to die now, but Jesus is telling, where is your faith? He is asking us, where is your faith and where is your hope? That is the most important questions today God is asking you and me. And this epidemic, we should see that our faith should not be unwavering. It should be unwavering faith, should not be wavering faith, should not be unstable, I mean. So that is very, very important thing. Now, having said these four spiritual truths, now we are going to come what God expects us to do. The first thing is true worship. Now, our inability to attend churches, I told you. Now, true worship, he wants our worship should be in truth and spirit. But if we see the pre-COVID area, there we see that the churches were empty and nobody, it is just like weekly event, weekly affair, just to go church, meet people, talk and come back, and the same thing again Sunday. These are the routine things, but here our worship should be true. It should be true worship. And another thing, that the churches are cold. It is only formal services are going on. There is no excitement, there is no zeal, or there is no other spiritual thing. We are lacking something. We are lacking spirituality in our worship. So let us ponder ourselves into the pre-COVID time and see that our worship should be holy one. It should be with truth and in spirit. And that is the main important thing God expects from you and me. That is true worship is very, very important thing. Now, second, now we have heard hundreds of sermons about Holy Spirit is speaking to us. The question, how many times we grieved Lord by partaking Lord's Supper? When the first Sunday of church we partake in the bread and cup of Jesus Christ, Lord's Supper, that time we, without any self-examination, we take that in an unworthy manner. There is no holiness and there is no spirituality in us. But this is very important thing. 1 Corinthians 11:28, it says, man ought to examine himself before he eats of the bread and drinks of the cup. So very, very important. God wants you and me true worship. It should be true worship. Now second is spiritual zeal. Now if you see the New Testament churches, the churches according to apostles' teaching, which are mentioned in the New Testament, they were having spiritual zeal and koinonia. Koinonia is the Greek word for fellowship. And this fellowship, they were in fellowship together in spite of lot of opposition. The church was growing in number day by day. But today, if we see, the churches are empty. There are more committee meetings than prayer meetings. And we need to check ourselves. Do we have spiritual zeal? Do we really spiritually deal with the Lord's, all these Lord is doing for us? We look at it in a spiritual way, or our worship is with a spiritual zeal? All these things, this is the greatest challenge that the modern churches are facing. And another thing, it's a desecration. If you go to Europe countries, the churches are converted into the entertainment centers and commercial hubs. Churches, earlier lot of good churches, but instead of fellowship, instead of church service, instead of worship, today people are enjoying there. And all sorts of nasty things are going on there. So, the very important thing, when I said, when before epidemic, we were having churches empty and nobody used to come. But when this epidemic started, the people are not able to come because of epidemic. And this is the difference. When there is a chance for you and me to come to church, we never bother about that. We don't have that zeal, spiritual zeal. We don't have that true worship. But we have that worldly things. We are always inclined to do worldly things. And this is a very, very important thing. For you and me, we need to concentrate on this. And the third very, very important thing, that is introspection. Now, that is a self-examination. God is talking us deeper things for introspection. Let us come to His sanctuary with penitence and contrition. So, my dear friends, when we do self-examination, where is our mind inclined? Are we going towards prosperity and riches? Or people's plans are failed in this epidemic. Prosperity and riches, no use. Epidemic, everything is failed. Worldly riches built on shaky foundation. God has no place or secondary role. So in this pandemic, we see that God has no role, secondary role. Those who stayed upon Jehovah, the Lord, were not dismayed or put to shame. So we need to find out the Lord. These things are there, but instead of giving importance to these worldly things, let us give importance to God. Let us approach God. Let us talk to Him. Let us listen to Him. And extravagance and lavishness. Now these are the antithesis of God's contentment and are opposite of God's contentment. We are interested in extravagance, having lot of money and other property and other things, lavishness. But you know, these people, they were completely failed during this epidemic. It is of no use. So, my dear friends, another thing, now government has control on family functions and marriages, but we used to see before COVID, lakhs of rupees were spent and wasted on these marriages and family functions. But today, God, instead of seeing spiritual things, or every ordinary people were forced to adopt such vestiges, fearing social stigma. And we are also doing same thing. Spiritual dimensions are sidelined. We are giving more importance to these things. What people will think? If I call only 25 people or 50 people for marriage, what people will think? This is not good. I have to call 1,000 people at least. These are the things. But this is mere vestige. So, my dear friends, this epidemic has taught us a lot of things. And we need to ponder into God's word. And God is telling us, come to me and have fellowship with me, have encounter with me. So please remember that people are jobless, and this is the time. God says, love thy neighbor. But we seeing people are jobless near us, neighbors, these are there, but we don't care. That means we don't follow what is God is telling us. So this pandemic is solemn, grim reminder that God is fulfilling His prophecies in His own time. So many godly believers are telling that these are the end time signs. These are the end time signs. And so signifying second coming of Jesus Christ. So let us believe that God always works for us. He talks with us through such pandemic and adverse situations. He refines and makes us more spiritual like Jesus. He assures us during such pandemics. He says, fear not, I am with you. And so let us worship the Lord, the Father, in truth and spirit. Let us have spiritual zeal rather than worldly contentment. And let us introspect ourselves so that we can live like Christ. Let us not lose control. Let us remember God is in control. So we have to be in control. So remember all the spiritual truths and God, what He wants us to do. Amen.
In behalf of Pastor Session and Valdemar Church, we want to thank you, Mr. Ashok Chokale, sir, for his beautiful and challenging sermon. Lastly, we all say prayerfully Lord's Prayer together. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. From thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory for ever and ever. Amen. May the God of peace, who through the blood of the eternal covenant brought back from the dead our Lord Jesus, that great shepherd of the sheep, equip you with everything good for doing His will, and may He work in us what is pleasing to Him, through Jesus Christ, to whom be glory for ever and ever. Amen.